If a pit bull is an athletic animal, being more of an explosive, powerful animal, or a very lean animal, or something in between, that's really a performance animal. What are all those others then? First, you have the American Staffordshire Terrier. That's a dog that's quite close to the pit bull, but more of a show version and less emphasized on performance, but more on looks. Also, many people say that there are certain lines that are a lot more often of American Pit Bull Terrier, which is ancestor breed, more often used in the Amstaff, so that you have they can also see this as a different line of American Pit Bull Terrier, but just for show purposes. So that could be one. So just a version that they can show, and also these type of dogs are also often better as a guard dog, because American Pit Bull Terriers were bred to be very human tolerant. Why? Because in the pit they had to be good with the handler, or their own handler, but also the opponent dog handler and the referee. If they were biting them, then they would be disqualified and losing. So that was also a characteristic that they were selected upon. Whereas the American Staffordshire Terrier was more of a show dog, so they didn't need this extreme human friendliness, and they also wanted to use it as a guard dog, so that they had more of a protection type of dog, like the American Bulldog as well, which also shares a lot of American Pit Bull Terrier blood in its ancestry. So that's one. And then there's the other thing. Then you have dogs that are band dogs, so they are crosses with, for example, molosses, especially for protection work, but also hand-stopping ability. So like ultimate type of guard dog, that could also be used on hogs, or a similar type of quarry, which is referring to prey. So those type of dogs you have. Example are also show versions thereof, like the re-established Cane Corso, but also Presa Canario, that are still being worked, but also being recognized as the FCE registered show breed under the name Dogo Canario. So that gives you some insight. And then you have the bullies. And oftentimes they call this bully pit bulls, but they are American bullies and should not be called pit bulls. They might have a small overlap with some pit bull blood, but just for street cred, that you say this is the ultimate gladiate, and then you come up with a very bulky, strong and intimidating looking type of dog, but that is losing a lot of functionality. But they are especially bully, and bully refers to a lot of bulldog blood, especially in the extreme and the small ones. You see those bow-legged paws and also very short noses very often in those bully breeds, and they are bred by introduction of all kinds of bulldogs. And the very small could be more of a French bulldog or a pug, and English bulldogs, and then the biggest also have English bulldogs and pug blood perhaps, but also blood such as bull mastiff, American bulldog, those types. And then you have also dogs that are more of the Presa Canario type, and I can't imagine that also those type of blood such as Presa Canario and other blood was used to make a very massive type of dog. But the Presa Canario is more of a performance breed than, for example, an English bulldog, which has a lot of show breed bred in through pug predominantly. The old working bulldog was very close to the American Pit Bull Terrier that is still performing. So there you have it. I hope you liked this video and also liked the insights that I tried to tell and give you some examples. The dog on the leash here is a Pettendale Terrier, 1.5 years old, PSL Estacado. Have a great day.